Robert Irwin. He is the wildlife warrior, proudly following in the footsteps of his dad, Australia's croc hunter, Steve.
But Robert recently went viral on TikTok after sharing a video of himself rescuing a snake.
Look at you, mate. How's it going?
You're all right, mate. Decent-sized snake. Hey, mate. Good job.
Just gorgeous. As you can see here, he's kind of constricting my hand. That's how they catch their prey. Coil back, grab the prey item, just smash it. They've got recurved teeth so that animal doesn't get away. And then they start wrapping it up. They asphyxiate it, kill it very quickly.
Now don't you bite me on the face. He's thinking about it.
All right, mate, let's get you off the road.
Oh,
wow. We're lucky enough to have Robert Irwin right here
get
in the studio.
Yay!
Amazing to have you just here.
Oh, it's so good. I know it feels weird not having the time delay between talking. It's so good to see you in person. I'm so stoked to be here. And unfortunately, I couldn't bring any snakes with me. I tried to get them on the plane. It didn't work.
But... Oh, snakes on a plane. Huh? Yeah. I've heard from reliable sources it can go wrong.
This is true.
But that video of you rescuing that snake has been viewed 19 million times.
Is that right?
Yes.
Yeah.
So
there you go.
Is that a how-to? Is that what everyday ordinary people should do if they find a snake?
I'm not saying you should go out there and do that, no, because if that was a venomous snake, I probably wouldn't be holding him right at my face.
No.
It was quite funny, actually, just a couple days later after I rescued that one, we had another one in a similar situation, and before I could even lay a glove on him, I was just covered in bites. So you just never know the demeanour they're going to be in. But what I want to stress with that is the fact that, well, you shouldn't go around picking up snakes. Snakes aren't out to get you. Mm. You know, you can see as I'm trying to move him, all that snake wants to do is go away. So we don't need to hate him and fear him. You want to keep your distance, but, yeah, they're a beautiful animal. Isn't he cute?
Aww.
He's so cool.
And look at you there in your civvies.
in me barefoot.
Exactly, yeah, no khaki.
Mufti.
Hey, you regularly come face-to-face with some very big crocodiles.
Yes.
How do you keep you cool?
Oh, I don't. Honestly, internally, you're just like, whoa, absolutely wigging out every time. If you weren't just filled with adrenaline every time you fed a croc, I mean, you wouldn't be human. It's a nerve-wracking experience because they're so unpredictable every time. But, you know, it's such an honour for me to get to continue my dad's legacy, you know, working with the animals that he loves so much, particularly crocs. A lot of them he rescued from the wild, gave them an amazing home at Australia Zoo, and I get to go in, show that wild behaviour. Instead of just throwing a piece of meat to an animal, we want to get in there and have them all using all those wild instincts, and we get to show people how spectacular these creatures are. I love every second of it, but there's definitely your moments where you go, that was too close.
Well, it was World Crocodile Day the other day, which
was.
I didn't know we had, but it's good. We should have had a big celebration.
That's right.
You no doubt did. You actually shared this touching post of both you and your father in action with crocs. How do you think he would feel with you following in his footsteps like that? And do you actually ever feel him with you when you're doing this?
Absolutely. It's a great question. And, yeah, I really do. I would hope more than anything he'd be proud. You know, growing up from such a young age, he instilled that passion for wildlife, for conservation, and just to love life, you know. He lived life so much to the fullest. He was such an intelligent, kind, caring, passionate, enthusiastic person. If I can be half the person he was, I'll be very, very happy. You know, it's big shoes to fill, but I feel like I can continue this legacy in my own way and keep his memory alive. It's a great honour, and every day working at Australia Zoo, I think he's with me and he's with us, and it's a pretty amazing person. The fact that all these years later, we still talk about him, and I have people come up to me all the time that'll say, you know, much older than I am, and they'll say, the reason I'm into zoology, the reason I went to university and studied whatever it was because of your dad, and that goes straight to my heart, and it's a big responsibility to keep that going, but something I take
that
on.
That could be quite emotional, though, too, people always bringing up your dad to you. How do you handle those emotional moments?
It's tough. It's tough. It really is. And there's two sides to it, you know. Yes, it is really hard when he's just a part of my life every day, and it is easy to be overcome with that emotion. But on the other side of that, it's very special because I get my whole life is captured on camera. So if I ever start to forget moments with Dad, rewind, press play, and there it is again. So in that way, I feel like I've got a lot more than a lot of other people might have, you know, if they've
Indeed.
Lost someone close to them. So I feel very, very lucky to have that. And, yeah, I just lucked out that I had a dad that was just 110%, loved us so much, And every second of every day he could spend with us, he was. So nothing but fond memories.
Yeah. You're such a beautiful young man, Robert Irwin. You're making me teary hearing you speak about your dad in that way. He would be so proud
of you.
And of your conservation work as well.
You've been
doing some great stuff, including a breeding program with African animals. Tell us about that.
This is true. Yeah, I mean, we have breeding programs with all kinds of different animals at Australia Zoo. Yeah, look at the little rhino.
Oh, my God, look at him.
I think that's Kingston. Just adorable.
Are rhinos the most dangerous animal in the world, or is it hippos?
Well, they reckon hippos are. I reckon every animal's dangerous to an extent, but it's just the way you work with them.
Yes.
You know, if you're kind to them, they'll be kind to you. But, yeah, we're all about conservation at the zoo, so we support many, many, many different wildlife and humanitarian efforts all over the world, and we're working on breeding up animals. We've actually got a giraffe that's due any minute. Oh. Actually, I don't know if... You may have just gotten a scoop. I don't even know if anyone knows that. So there you go.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's big news. There's a lot happening at the zoo and we're very, very happy.
I've got a lot of admiration for giraffes. I wouldn't want to give birth to a giraffe.
No.
They've got 4 7-foot onto the ground standing up.
Oh, really?
It's a spectacle. It's a lot to witness.
There's a lot.
We never had to have, the birds and the bees chat as a kid because it's all happening right there.
You would have seen some things.
I have.
And you've probably snapped a few shots. You're a wizard with the camera. You're a great photographer.
Thank you.
You're launching a photography competition, launched a photography competition with Crikey Magazine. What can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so we've got our quarterly magazine, Crikey Magazine. Photography's been a very big passion for me for a lot of years, and we wanted to create something to hopefully spread the conservation message through images. That's what photography is about.
So these are your photos?
Yeah, these are all mine.
I
love going out and, you know, showcasing just the beauty of our natural world. So entries are open. You can head over to the Australia Zoo website and have a look and get your photos in there. And it's now become one of the biggest competitions in Australia.
Look at that.
I get to be one of the judges. It's so much fun. We love it. Yeah.
Who taught you how to use the camera?
You know, I sort of learnt really just myself, kind of experimenting, trial and error. I've had a lot of great photography mentors in my life, but I've gotten to sort of learn as I go. My dad was actually a passionate photographer too.
Wow.
A lot of people don't know that. And I think it's just genetic, a lot of it.
You've got a great eye.
He loved it.
Yeah.
And you need a lot of patience as well to get those shots,
don't you? It's the only thing I really truly can sit down in one spot for an hour is if I'm photographing something. Oh. Otherwise, it's just go, 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 go.
You're full lying down hiding.
Exactly.
You had to get a snake poking his tongue out right at your camera. Yeah. How close were you to
it? Oh, very close. Very close. In the next frame, his mouth's covering the lens. He gave it a good little bite.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. But I that's the fun for me is a lot of people... You know, they want to have this one-on-one connection with wildlife. If I can go out, put my body on the line and showcase nature in its truest, most raw kind of format, that's what's going to get animals into your heart. Mm. You know, you want to have that one-on-one connection, and that's what it's all about. So if I can do that in front of the lens and behind the lens, then, you know, I've done my job, yeah.
You're 18, you're a wildlife warrior, you're a conservationist. And you're also a little bit of a heartbreaker these days, young man.
Oh, no.
Can we please ask about this moment? Can I just say, if I saw one of my sons acting the way you were, I would know that I've done my job right as a mum. It's the most beautiful thing. Have a look at this. This is blowing up on TikTok. One of the audience members.
Well, I'm very flattered. Thank you. Where are you visiting from?
America.
Oh, nice. That's good. Whereabouts?
Utah.
Cool. Oh, no, Utah's great. Yeah, well, I tell you what, the easiest way is usually like on Instagram, because then my people can look at it and monitor it and see when it comes through.
Okay.
Because my number's hit and miss.
Okay, but this is so random, but I actually DM'd you last night to tell you I was coming here today.
Oh, no. Okay, well, what was your name?
Megan Grass.
Okay, I'll look it up.
Perfect.
Okay. No,
now you know the question we're going to ask.
I do know the question you're going to ask.
Did you look her up?
good question. it was honestly.
How do you deal with that though?
That made my entire day. That was incredibly kind, and a big thank you to Megan wherever she is. That really meant a lot. It really did. You know, it's hard. I can't really just go out and give my number out, and because it's all over TikTok, and I hadn't met her before. I'm out of range all the time. You know, all that. But it was very flattering, very kind, and you know, kudos for the confidence to ask that. And it was great to have that little chat and see people who are really keen on you know the message I'm sending out there, obviously, and listening to what I'm doing. It meant the world. And yeah, I was, yeah, very, very appreciative.
Oh. We adore you, Robert.
You can come and see us anytime.
Thank you very much. And same goes for you guys. Anytime you want to come to Australia Zoo, cuddle a koala, mate, you're always welcome.
I have the most fun up there. It's such a special
good
place.
Good times, definitely.
Uncle Bob, a quick, how's your little niece, Grace?
So good.
Funkle?
Funkle Robert, yes, that's it. I'm loving every second of it. Grace is the greatest little kid. She's so smart, she's so happy, loves animals. Tortoises are her favourites.
Right.
Obsessed with tortoises. And, proudest uncle on earth, absolutely.
Would you put your hands together for Robert Irwin?
Thank you. Good on you. Good to see you.